In part one, chapter two of A Clockwork Orange, the gang hears a drunk outside the bar and his belches and filthy clothes disgust Alex. Dim hits the man in the gut as the drunk complains about living in a stinking world like this one, where law and order no longer exist despite technological progress that has put men on the moon. The gang beats the man until he vomits blood, then they leave. They run into Billy Boy and his gang near the power plant. Billy Boy and Leo are restraining a young girl, preparing to rape her, but they let her go to fight Alex's gang. Alex is excited for a brawl. Dim knocks Leo out of the fight, and Alex waltzes around Billy Boy, whose weight makes him slow, bloodying his face. When the gang hears sirens, Alex and the boys hide in a dark alley as Dim watches the moon until Alex urges them on to their next violent adventure. They steal a car and speed into the countryside, pausing to ram the car into a kissing couple before seeking a chance for the old surprise attack. Alex knocks at an isolated cottage with the name Home on its gate, feigning that a friend has been injured. When the young woman who opens the door a crack says they have no phone, Alex asks for a cup of water. Reassured by his polite manner, she goes to get it, and Alex and his boys put on their masks and barge in to confront the woman and her husband, a writer seated at his desk. Alex picks up the top sheet of a manuscript and reads the gloopy title, A Clockwork Orange, and sentences describing humans as capable of sweetness and change as opposed to mechanical things. Alex shreds the pages, laughing as Dim beats the writer bloody and the young woman shrieks. Georgie and Pete gobble down their food until a disgusted Alex commands them to restrain the writer. Dim holds the woman so that Alex can rip her clothing to expose her breasts. Alex rapes her and then trades places with Dim, Georgie, and Pete, who also viciously rape the woman as her husband screams obscenities. Alex narrates encounters that reveal more about the novel's dystopian world, especially the drunk's lament about how the level of technology has not been accompanied by ethical advances in humanity. No one cares for earthly law and order now. Readers also see Alex's traits as a leader emerge in this chapter, but they're traits that aren't positive. He demands quick and total obedience from his gang. Like the state he lives in, Alex is dictatorial.